Yo, Macklemore. Yeah, I'm gonna go buy some lights now.
I went to the moped store, said fuck it. And the salesman's like, what up? What's your budget? And I'm like, honestly, I don't know nothing about mopeds. He said,
I got the one for you. Follow me.
Ooh, it's too real. Chrome down mirror, I don't need a windshield. Banana seat, a canopy on two wheels. 800 cash, that's a hell of a deal.
No, it's not. It's not a good deal. What? What's up, guys? My name is Dax Berlay. We've all been there looking to buy new lights. You want to get RGB lights. You want to get these special lights. You want to get these lights that just flash and just make your life better, but you don't have the money. Well, in this video, I'm going to walk you through a quick tip that I use to make RGB lights, to make any color gel light for literally like free. Not free, but very, very cheap. So let me walk you through this. This is what I'm talking about. These are pretty much clear paper, is what I'm gonna call it. So you can buy rolls like these at stores like Staples, I believe, Michaels, I believe, Walmart probably, craft store, any craft store. Pretty much what it is, it's just a film. The light will go through, it'll change the color. I'm gonna show you guys how to set these up, how to use them safely, and then I'm also gonna throw in a couple little interesting tips for you guys that I use to make your money worth triple. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna take a nice light that you have. You can use any light that you have. You can actually even use like a house lamp if you really want to, but this is the light I'm gonna be using. It's just a little simple LED panel. And as you can see, that's bright, bro. That's like, you know, like when you open the curtains in the morning and like it's bright as hell and you're like, whoa! That's what that's like. You wanna get a slice of your paper, whatever color you get. For now, I'm gonna get red and blue. I will tell you this paper is very flimsy. Like it's hard to keep like organized. I'm gonna get scissors to cut it. And I found these scissors. It looks like they're from like the movie Us. We're just gonna cut a slice. Now, I need another thing, I need tape. So I'm gonna be using this painter's tape. Gaff tape would probably be better. It doesn't stick too much. It just sticks enough to hold it down in place. You know how to do this. I don't even know why I'm explaining this. You have situations where I don't even use tape. I just kind of shove it around the thing and then hope it stays. But bang, there you go. Now it is wrapped and simply you just turn the bad boy on and there you go. Now it's red. One thing to note is that this does diffuse the light. It makes the light less strong. You're not gonna get the full power of the light. And one thing to note too is the more layers you put on, the less power you get. This is me in the dark with four layers of blue tape on. So one layer will obviously make it red. The more layers you put on, the more red it'll be, but the less powerful it'll be. Be careful of forest fires. Be careful of fires. I've never had an issue with fires, not with LEDs, because these don't heat up too much. Incandescent bulbs, for example, this one right here lighting me up isn't incandescent. So if you're gonna throw those on, you have to be careful because it does heat it up. This stuff is not flammable, I don't think. It could melt, but still beware. You know, don't go around just shoving it like right in the bulb and hoping it doesn't and leaving it on all day. Mix and match for more fun. If you remember when you were in grade, you know, 3 or 4, you learned your color chart. I don't remember mine, so we're gonna just experiment and see what red and blue mix. You can get two rolls and you can make 3 colors, but this is pretty much now a purple light. See how the power has really softened, but I'm gonna leave links in the description if you can order them online. And I'm gonna finally tell you a quick tip. If you want even more colors out of this, all you have to do is use Lumetri color and you can completely change the RGB light. As you can see up here, this is actually softbox with one of these blue filters on it. And as you can see, it's light blue, but I'm gonna show you quickly. Bang. Bang, bang. You can change the color using Lumetri color as long as the original color is really different than skin tones and things like that. But I'm gonna quickly show you how to do this in Premiere Pro. Let's hop in the computer. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna come to curves. You're gonna wanna come to hue versus hue. Of course, you wanna come here with the eyedropper, select the green. I would suggest just making these a little wider so it's a little more of a gradual change. And then you can come here and you can completely change it. As you can see here, it's a dance party. And you can choose what color you want to make it. And there you go. Now your color is changed. So yeah, this really lets you play with what the colors are gonna be. Now I have these two colors and these both can transfer into both 5 different colors. So I have 10 different colors. This technique is just so useful, so cheap. Link in bio, of course, where you can buy these gels or you can go to your local craft store. Question of the day for you guys. What is your favorite color? Since we're on the topic of colors, comment below. Mine is yellow at the moment. Hope you guys learned something in this video. Hope you enjoyed. Gently tap that like button. If you did enjoy, subscribe. New videos every week. Hit that notification bell if you want to be notified. Creators, keep creating. See you guys in the next one.